Nityanandam, welcome back to Nityananda Dhyanapitam, Bidadi. You are watching the evening news on Nityananda Web TV on Tuesday, August 24, 2010. In his message today, Swamiji spoke on living with the Master. It was a beautiful talk on how the Master puts you through tough situations to push you along faster on your path to enlightenment. We can say from experience that living with the Master is an intense experience where living enlightenment becomes a way of life. Please visit www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation to view the full message. Today was also the inaugural day of the free living enlightenment process. The first batch for this process of over 150 people from across the world were warmly welcomed at the ashram. They will be undergoing an intense spiritual process for the next 48 days along with the ashramites. To celebrate their arrival, Swamiji performed a grand Abhishekam or holy bath to the 21 feet Anandalinga using milk, turmeric, sandalwood, sacred ash and flowers. Later in the evening, he spent time with them explaining the process and what they can expect in the next 48 days. Let us watch a small clip of the inaugural day.
I think I can give only this as an introduction. Living enlightenment process is living enlightenment process. Maybe I can give you the story of how this program happened in me. Hatha Yoga means the science of becoming enlightened and science of preparing the body for enlightenment. You can say the science of bolting the enlightenment experience in your physiology. So that is Hatha Yoga. He's a great master, Swatmarama. I was just going through his books, his works. He was talking about the technique of changing the very shape of your body, the very physiology, just by altering the breath, nothing else. Just if you stop the one side nostril and shift the flow to the other side, just stopping the one side and shifting the flow to the other side, just playing with the flow of breath, flow of breathing, very playfully, the very physiological structure can be changed. The very size of the muscles, the very size of the hands, legs, eyes, the very physiological structure can be changed.
In other news, the devotee staged a strong but peaceful protest at the office of the Superintendent of Police or SP in Ramnagara, demanding immediately lodging an FIR against Lenin Karupan based on their complaints. The devotees, significantly both men and women, had approached Bididi police station on August 9th and submitted individual complaints against Lenin, stating that he was continuing to abuse Swamiji, his organization and ashramites in public and private. Earlier this year, Lenin had gone on local and national TV to declare that over 40 women, including brahmacharinis and sannyasis of the ashram, wives and daughters of the local organizers, all had had a physical relationship with Swamiji. In response to these and other accusations, the devotees had approached the Bididi police station to file a complaint. However, the Bididi police refused to lodge even a single FIR against Lenin. After waiting 15 days, the devotees again approached the police yesterday with the same result. Once again, no FIR was lodged against Lenin. By law, an FIR should be filed on the spot when a complaint is lodged with the police. Refusing to file an FIR is illegal. So today, the devotees and supporters approached the SP demanding their FIRs be filed. However, the Ramnagar SP was unavailable to meet them, and once again, the FIR was not lodged. The SP of police, Sri Bisana Halli, had directed the devotees to return to the Bididi police station tomorrow to request once again that an FIR be lodged. So in this way, Swamiji's local, national and international devotees await in vain for the very first step of justice. Well, that was from today. We'll keep you posted on the happenings on this issue. That's all for today. We will come back with more news tomorrow, same time on Nityananda Web TV. Nityananda.